Hello and welcome to Focus on Israel and the Palestinian Territories. I am Paul Calvert. And I sat down with Salamah Bishara, the headmaster, and asked him how long he's been at the school.
I've been the headmaster for the past 3 years.
How many students do you have here in the school?
We have 465 students, most of which are Christians of all denominations, and 18% of Muslims, and we live as the Palestinian society in harmony all together.
How easy is it to be headmaster with the current situation that you have here in the land?
It's pretty much difficult, and it's getting more and more difficult, especially economically and politically, because many families find it difficult to find jobs that is suitable for them. Here in Beit Sahur, especially in our town, 80% of the families live of tourist-related industries. And since the second intifada in the year 2000, a lot of families lost their income. This brought a lot of families into dire straits, which made it in some ways a lot difficult for families to pay their tuition fees or registration fees or expenses for kids, for their kids to send their children to a private school. Even though our school is considered one of the lowest tuition fees, a lot of families are finding it more and more difficult to send them to our school. Also, another big challenge is the immigration. Every year, many Christian families leave Beit Sahur to Europe and to the States, which makes it more hard, more difficult for a principal to keep the level of Christian students and the enrollment as a general in our schools.
So these children who can't afford to pay their enrollment fees, do they have to go to a Muslim state school?
Some do, but the problem is not just the Muslim state school, which is getting better and better, but we are losing Christian families to immigration, which is more of our concern rather than going to other school which has lower tuition fees. Of course, our school, what we charge the tuition fees only covers less than 30% of the actual cost of each student. But out of these even the 30%, most families never pay the full tuition fees. Most of them has either sponsorship program or exemptions or deductions or someone else pays for them. And even with all this, a lot of families find it difficult to pay the tuition fees. Even the Muslims families send their children to our schools because they know that we provide a little bit better education than the governmental schools. And also they know that we promote peace education, democracy, openness, coexistence between the all religions.
Now, the Middle East is a place with lots of hatred. How do you keep that hatred out of the school?
We have a lot of courses, workshops, classes, periods that we integrate classes with that teach coexistence and among the three major religions, that means Judaism, Islam, and Christianity. And once in every fortnight, classes are joined together, Muslims and Christians, to be taught of these three common factors of these three religions. And we emphasize that we are all should live together in harmony, in peace, in this land.
Now, I know in the West there's a big problem with things like drugs and guns. Do you have any problems with that at all here in school?
Not at all. We never faced a problem with drugs or guns. It is totally forbidden to bring any gun or even firecrackers to the school. And of course, drugs is a minor, or rather no problem at all in of our schools. Even smoking is not allowed, and every case, small case of smoking is dealt with our social worker and through lectures and speakers who discourage our youth not to smoke.
Mm. Now, is the Christian faith important for the school?
It's very important. It's one of our pillars of our school, and it's, as I said, it's one of our eight goals of the school, because this is called the Evangelical Lutheran School, and as a school, as this Christian school, we emphasize on praying, on the Bible, on studying the Bible. Every morning we have a morning devotion, and kids, before they leave, they pray before leaving school.
Now, what sort of special events do you do here with the students?
This needs a lot of time, because we are known as a school of many events, besides the usual Christmas celebration, Mother's Day plays, the graduations of both the Tawjih, which is the end of the class 12, and the kindergarten graduation. We usually have sport festivals, art festivals, book exhibitions. We have field days, we have open days, and our students enjoy every week going swimming. We have about 17 different activities of extracurricular activities, like music, playing instrument, our choir, our dabke, which is the folklore dance group. We are going this summer to Switzerland to perform.
Wow.
With the choir and the dabke. We have many exchange programs with Germany, with Sweden, with Denmark. I have about this year about 70 students going in exchange programs besides Switzerland. Three groups going to Germany, one group probably in August going to Sweden, and another group going to Egypt. So we have many activities, and it's our part of our holistic approach, that a student is not in our school just for the academic education, but also to be educated in sports, in arts, in music, in vocational education, which is really big in our school. We have many workshops to train, and for the students to train on vocational education, also to appreciate handwork, handcraft, and art.
So you sound very, very busy then.
We are very busy.
Now, you're based here in Beit Sahur. The school is based here. What's special about Beit Sahur?
Oh, Beit Sahur is what is believed the place where the angel spread the word to the shepherds, and we have the shepherd field. Beit Sahur is also a Christian, one of the few Christian towns, and it's a good place to be.
Mm. Now, you told me your name is Salamah Bishara. What does that mean?
Actually, Bishara means the gospel, good news. And we are Christians since probably the time of Jesus. We are Arabs, and we are Christians.